Caviar, and I'm an activist against the deportation policy of the Netherlands, and also the policy of Fortress of Europe. And I'm part of a few groups that do actions against deportations. Well, for me it was mainly because people always talk about racism, and they talk about Geert Wilders, who is a politician who is as obviously racist in Dutch politics as people know. And I feel that in fact the whole policy against migrants is racist in itself, because it's a separate policy for a separate group of people meant to kick them out of the country, to deport them, to lock them up. And that in itself is racist. And nobody talks about that on a manifestation like is happening on the Dam right now. They're only talking about Wilders and about, you know, the most obvious racism there is. But in the meantime, a party like the PvdA is also there with a stand. And I mean, they're responsible for the whole migration policy right now. I mean, we had Albarak strengthening the policy against migration. And we had Cohen, who invented the current regime against migrants. And they're both PvdA politicians. And PvdA is there pretending to be very anti-racist and stuff like that. And people need to see that racism is everywhere. It's in the whole society. And it's in the policy that we have against migration, against migrants, people who are to be called illegal and are being locked up and deported. And well, that's all racist as well. It's not just Wilders, you know. It's just Wilders is only an exponent of that racism. It's the most obvious. And I think that other politicians like to deter the attention away from their policy by pointing at Wilders. He's the racist, but we're not. Meanwhile, they're, you know, doing the things they do. And so that's why, for me, this demonstration was important. I think people should not vote at all, because there is no political party in the Netherlands that is opposing migration detention. They're all for it. They only have, you know, degrees of severity of how the policy is being performed. I mean, they're all for detention centers, but Wilders is more openly. And I think, because they're all for it, you shouldn't vote at all for all of them. You should take action yourself against this policy as a whole, against capitalism, against the Fortress of Europe, and against locking people up and calling them illegal. And take the right into your own hands, and take action at what level whatever is suitable for you is better than to vote for any politician at all. What people can do is they can join groups that already exist and take part in campaigns that are already happening. For example, there's the campaign against the uitzendbureaus, the renting of guards for detention centers. And there's actions taken against the new detention centers that are being built. There are actions against the charter flights, of the Frontex charter flights. And, you know, they can take several forms. You can go and demonstrate like today, or have a blockade or an occupation, or maybe throw in a few windows at night. You know, there are a lot of options that people can think of that I don't need to mention, I think. Whatever is good for you. Yeah. It's been happening the past like 3 years when Albarak was doing the migration policy. She made it worse and worse and worse. And for example, the foreign police, they have a lot more things they can do when they, for example, enter a house of somebody who is being called illegal, and they arrest the person. They may also like search the house and take the phone and look into the phone what contacts people have, and they have. They may do so many things. There are checks for ID on the streets that are racist. And these things are happening now. We don't need Wilders to make that happen. It's already happening. And it's happening under Cohen. It's happening under Albayrak. It doesn't make a lot of difference. It's only a slight difference. But I think in order to make it clear that this shouldn't happen at all, you just should vote and you should take action yourself and tell any politician that is in power that this should stop. Their message is less obvious. They dress it up, kind of. I don't know how to say this in English. But they make it seem like it's reasonable. And I think that's even more dangerous than the blatant racism of Wilders. Because people don't know this. They don't know. And Wilders is very obvious. He's a racist, you know. It's so clear. And I think it's easier, in fact, to be fighting a person like Wilders than to be fighting a person like Cohen or Albayrak, because they make it seem so reasonable. And it's not reasonable. And that's why I think it doesn't matter. And it's, no, I really think that that we should fight them all, no matter who is in power. And the message should always be no deportations, no exploiting the third world and the people who are living in the Netherlands trying to survive, because that's in fact all they do, is try to survive on the streets, and they have to do very hard work and are exploited in many ways. And this won't change whether it's Wilders or Cohen. People are coming from a situation that is even worse than living here in illegality or being locked up in the Netherlands. And because the situation in the countries they're coming from is so bad, for whatever reason, it may be environmental, it may be poverty, it may be war or some form of persecution, the situation is always worse from where they're coming than here. So, I mean, it should ring a bell to people that people would rather live in illegality in the Netherlands or in France or Belgium or whatever, or being locked up here. I'd rather have that than to go back. I mean, that's a sign, isn't it? Only a very few people can get asylum in the Netherlands, and those people are actually chosen, preferably by the government, because they want to pick the people they can use. Do you know the so-called brain drain? They take people from third world countries they can use because they bring in knowledge or they bring in money. But anybody who doesn't have that would rather be kicked out, because they bring poverty, that's what has been said, right? They bring poverty or they bring crime or whatever. That's always been repeated over and over again, also by Cohen and by Albarak and people like that. You know, people should be able to just move wherever they want and live wherever they want, whether that's in the Netherlands or in France or whatever, just because there is no reasonable dividing of wealth in the world. I mean, we exploit, and because we exploit, other people should have the right to be here. I mean, there's tolerance as long as we can use people. If we can use so-called gastarbeiters, workers, you know, or if we can use the knowledge, okay, people are welcome. And that's tolerance for you in the Netherlands, you know, if we can use you. If we cannot use you, just kick you out. Racism is so much grounded in society right now that people think, what are you talking about? We're not racist. And I think a lot of people just don't recognize racism anymore. What has been called reasonable today was called racism back in the 80s. And that's how you can see that tolerance in the Netherlands actually never was. I mean, maybe a bit, but it's only been an image. And it's good for tourism. Ignorance does play a role, but politicians are also preying on ignorance and making people ignorant by just repeating that story that our wealth is ours and our freedom is ours, and that we cannot use migrants because they bring crime, they bring poverty. I mean, that story has been told over and over again, and that is making people ignorant, that is making people not realizing that slowly and gradually we are becoming a more and more racist and nationalistic society, because people think it's normal. And I think we should be keeping and continuing to point out that this is not normal. And people should wake up and really start to think about what's going on and just not believe everything that has been said by politicians or the press.